everyone. We were doing chapter number 1 and now we are going to summarize the topic generations of computer. First generation of computer, which was from 1940 to 56, it consists of vacuum tubes, and the storage medium used was for magnetic tapes to store data. Language used here was machine language, that is the language of zeros and ones. It is also known as binary language, language of bits. And input we do with the help of punch cards and paper tape. Now, what are punch cards? Punch cards are the stiff paper that are used for inputting data in the form of zeros and ones. Output was displayed through printouts, and these computers were slow, expensive and large in size and consumed a lot of energy. For example, for this computers were UNIVAC, ENIAC and EDVAC. Next was second generation of computers. It was from 1956 to 1963. These computers used the technology of transistors and instead of vacuum tubes. First generation computers, these computers relied on magnetic tapes. Now, what are magnetic tapes? Magnetic tapes are actually the small plastic thin tapes which are coated with magnetized material, and it is used for storing data. Next was second generation computers moved from the machine language. In this computers, assembly language was used. Assembly language is similar to our English language, and the examples of assembly language are Fortran, COBOL, BASIC, etc. Here also punch card and paper tapes were used as input devices and output devices as printout. Output was given through printout. These computers were faster, cheaper, smaller and more efficient as compared to first generation computers. Examples were IBM 1400, IBM 350, etc. Next is third generation computers. It was from 1964 to 71. It uses ICs. ICs, what are ICs? Integrated circuits. That is a chip having lot of circuitry on its board. Magnetic disks were used for storage. The languages used in this generation was Pascal and RPG. These computers were smaller in size. They were having huge storage capacity and higher calculating speed as compared to first generation and second generation. They were more reliable. We can more rely on this. They were more accurate, and so we can rely more on it. And the input devices used here was keyboard. Output devices were monitors and printers. Examples of this generation are IBM System 360 and Apple I Altair are examples of this generation. Next is fourth generation of computers. It was from 1972 to present generation. Fourth generation computers uses more higher technology, which was known as very large scale integrated circuits, that is VLSI-C, and also known as microprocessors. High capacity magnetic disks were used for storage in this generation. Input was done through keyboard, mouse and scanner. Besides monitor and printer, there were two more devices as output device, plotters and speakers. Next is these generation computers can be linked together to share storage capacity, space, data, etc. That was internet was came into use in this generation. We can share data linking more than two or more computers. Next is the use of microprocessors resulted in decrease in size. The size of the computer was much decreased as compared to first, second and third generation, and their efficiency was increased. These computers were portable. We can carry the computer from one place to another, reliable and cheapest among all the other generations. Examples of fourth generation are Apple Macintosh, IBM PC, etc. Next generation is the fifth generation. It was from present to beyond, means from now onwards the computer which are used, they are known in the category of fifth generation computers. Fifth generation computers involve artificial intelligence, that is also known as AI, where computers can behave, think and react the same way as human beings do. That means the computer can have the power of what to do, when to do and how to do, and all these things was programmed by the human beings itself. It is known as artificial intelligence. Next is, these computers are still in development, though there are some applications such as voice recognition are being used today. The goal of fifth generation computing is to develop devices that respond to natural language and to imitate human reasoning. As we know how robots are being used in various fields, so robots come in the category of fifth generation computers that recognize our voice and follow our commands. Next is characteristics of computers. Characteristics of computers can also be known as advantages of computers, or you can call as the features of computers. First is the speed. Speed is in what amount of time that one computer can do one particular task. A computer can store very large amount of data and can do calculations, any complex calculations, difficult calculations in small amount of time. Second is accuracy. Accuracy means the degree of perfection of operations performed by a computer. That means computer can do the same calculation in one go. And if you try that calculation 2 times, 3 times, 10 times, 100 times, the answer will be the same. Next is reliability. Reliability refers to the quality of a computer system to perform consistently well and complete its allotted duties on time without experiencing any system failure. That means reliability here means if you use the computer today and after 1 month you use that computer, or after 1 year you use that computer, it will give you the same result in same amount of time without making any mistake. Next is versatility. A computer perform a variety of tasks. Variety means many tasks at the same time. Therefore, it can be almost all fields. It can be used in almost all fields in education, science, technology, business. In education, teachers are using computers to teach their students the lesson plans, showing them PPTs. In science and technology, the scientists are using for creating new inventions. Business also it is used, and so other fields are also using the computer. That is why it is versatile. Next is storage. Storage is the capacity of a computer to store data. Computer can store large amount of data which can be used anytime. Once the data is stored in the computer, it can be used as many times as you want. And the storage in computer is mainly of 2 types, the main memory or the primary memory and the secondary memory or the external memory. Main memory or the primary memory consists of RAM and ROM. RAM is random access memory, ROM is read-only memory. And also we have external storage devices, secondary storage devices. They can be CD, pen drive, hard disk. And hard disk can store the maximum amount of data among these. Users can use many other devices to store the data depending upon the capacity of the data which you are storing. Next point is diligence. Diligence are computers can never be tired, or they can never feel fatigue or boredom. As human beings do the repetitive work, they feel bored and they feel tired. But computer as a machine, they don't feel any fatigue or tired or any such things. So this is called diligence. Next is multitasking. Multitasking means to do various tasks at the same time. For example, when you're switching on the computer, you are playing game. One task you are doing. Second task you can do is you can listen to music through any media player. Third task is you can give the print command to the printer. So in this way you are doing 3 tasks at the same time. This is called multitasking. Next is limitations of computer. Limitations here means the disadvantages of computer. First is incapability to think. Like human beings, computer cannot think on its own. It has to use all the programs or step-by-step instructions which we give to the computer to think and process forward. Next is no intelligence. Computer is not having intelligence quotient, that is IQ. Unlike human beings, he cannot think for himself or herself what is good or what is bad for him. A computer has to follow stepwise instructions. Next is dependence on powers. Dependence on power, as we know, computer is electronic machine, so it works on electricity. Once the electricity is shut down, the computer will shut down automatically. And so the dependence on power is one of the disadvantages of using computer.